And in the midst of all this thing, there comes spirit of praise and spirit music. And remember, spirit music is a mother of spirit of praise and all the artists that are there. So, Aubrey Peacock, after my song, Higher, in Spirit of Praise, Volume 3, he then called me to his office and said, I see a potential. People, they love and they like that song that you did. How about we sign you as an artist? You know, man. Yeah, you know, I was so excited, you know, being called by Spirit Music, you know, and when I came to his office, one thing I picked up, I saw pictures of Benjamin Juvier on the wall, being part of the artists that were signed by there. I said, wow, this is it for me. And he gave me an opportunity, man. He made me sign a contract, and he released an album, and we titled Higher. That was the name of the song, so that people might relate easy to it. And then, of course, because now I was in that phase of starting to be in public, people starting to learn who is Omega is. You know, it did well, but it did not do well. You know, I think for them, how it sold, it was okay for a person who's studying as an artist. So it gave them hope that we can still keep this boy and grow with him. And then after that project, Spirit of Praise, including Bishop Benjamin and Aubrey, they sat down and said, no, man, for now, as we're doing Spirit of Praise 4, we want to invite Omega, now not as a choir member. You must see God there. Not as a choir member now, but as one of the artists. That means I'm not going to wear a uniform of the choir. I'm not going to go to rehearsals like they are going, like I was doing. I was going to be invited only on my day of rehearsal and do my songs. And I was promoted. And when I remember from Volume 3, I was part of the choir. Man, now I'm sitting there with the bishop in those couches as an artist, from a taxi driver, you know, from a person who slept at Park Station. So for me, I saw the grace of God. So they called me for Spirit of Praise Volume 4, and I did a song called Enter Bene and Udumo Molimeku. Those songs, my friend. Those songs, they took me even beyond the borders of South Africa. You know, they took me, I even went to the UK because of the platform. I normally say to Aubrey Peacock, you don't know how Spirit of Praise is big. You must ask me, I will tell you, because I got bookings, not even from my project, from Spirit of Praise. People from the UK saw me doing my songs as Spirit of Praise, so it took me even beyond. And I went now to Spirit of Praise Volume 5, and before Spirit of Praise Volume 5, actually, I did another project called Crossover as a live DVD recording. And then now Spirit of Praise Spirit Music was involved in there as well to produce that album. And then I did those songs as well there. So people, they bought it from there as well. Now they invited me to Spirit of Praise Volume 5. And when I go to Volume 5, I did a song called Busa, Jesu Busa. And when I was doing that song, me and my wife, we lost another child. You know, the devil attacked us, we got another miscarriage. When I was raising Busa, I saw her calling. She called, and it was my turn now to raise. I could see that, you know, something is wrong there. And then after I did that song, I went outside and called her, and she gave me the disappointment. And I didn't even tell the choir, I didn't even tell the bishop. I just continued to raise. And when we got to Carnival City, we were recording at Carnival City. I remember I was crying. If you can check that video, and by God's grace, that is your video on YouTube, is even over 1 million views, because I was crying. And people, they thinking that, you know, Omega, maybe that song got him emotional, maybe the presence of the Lord. No, it was not all about that. I was breaking my heart because we just lost the child. And then I was crying to God bitterly. The bishop, they didn't know. And I even called Bishop Benjamin Dube to help me in that song, because I could not carry it anymore. He joined me on stage. He continued singing it. But I was inside, man, I was broken. And I said, I think it was an opportunity to cry in my heart. And all 5,000 people that were there at Carnival, they saw me cry on stage. And they were thinking, maybe, no, Omega, only to find out that, man, I was breaking my heart. So I'm excited now. I'm part of Spirit of Praise Volume 6, and it's exciting.
The presence of the Lord is in this place. You are the King. You are the King. Lion of Judah. Reign Jesus. Reign Jesus.
Being part of Spirit of Praise 7 now, from volume 3 up until volume 7 right now, this means a lot to me. And then remember, 7 is a number of completion. It's a perfect number. So now I believe that this is a message to me. When Bishop Benjamin Dube and Aubrey Pico gave us the theme for this thing, I said, this theme is for me. Because I believe now that God is putting everything to be perfect and to be completed. Because now I'm from Rome 3 and now it's 7. And I'm still part of this family. And things are still going good. So I'm really thankful to God. It means a lot to me. When I go to Carnival City and on the 7th of July, I'll just say to God, now this is perfect.